Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about introduction to arrays in Java. So what is a need of an array? We may need to structure the memory to store numerous data items by applying minimum set of variables and by using optimum memory space. So if you want to store some set of data in the memory, you need a structure, okay, which uses minimum set of variables to store the list of data in that. So this logical structure is called as a dimensional array. A dimensional array is a structure created in the memory to represent a number of same type of data with the help of single variable. So this variable, that is array variable, is a structure which is used to create memory space and store the data into that of same data type. So you cannot have different data types into a single same variable. If you create an integer array variable, you will store only integer values in there. If you create a character array, you will store only character values in there. Okay, so you will have two types of dimensional array. One is single dimensional array, another one is double dimensional array. So first we will see about single dimensional array. When the elements are specified by a single subscript, so you will have a subscript. Subscript is nothing but the index values, or you can say the position value. So suppose if you have an array of size 10, you can store 10 different values in that. So you can see the boxes here, you can store 10 different values. You can see the subscript values, which is starting from 0. Subscript always begins with 0th position and then it goes on till 9, because since the array size is 10, it goes on till 9. So you will have totally 10 numbers. Suppose if you want to invoke the 5th element, actually you have to specify the position value. So the position value is 4 for the 5th element. Okay, so like that you have to change the subscript value according to the necessity. Now we are going to see how to declare an array. So you got different data types in the left hand side, and right hand side is the format to be used for each data type. So you can see integer, you need to use integer keyword and the array variable with open and close square bracket, that is should be empty, then equal to sign, then a new operator, and then you will have integer keyword again, and then the subscript value. So this 10 will represent the total number of elements you can store it in this array. So here you can store 10 different numbers, 10 different integer values in this array, that is m is the array variable. Same like that you can create it for float. Only thing is the data type has to be changed, and for character you have to put char, and then for string you have to put string here. So automatically you can change the subscript values according to the necessity of the program. Okay, if the program says you need 5 elements, you can put it as 5. If the program says 15 elements, you change it to 15. So like that you can do it. Now we are going to see how to use an integer input using assignment statement. So you can directly assign the values, as you would have seen in normal variable. Array variable also, you can assign the values and then use it in the program. So how to assign it is, you need to use the data type first, and the array variable, ARR is the array variable here, and open and close bracket, which indicates it is an open array. It can store any number of values in this. According to the values you specified in the bracket, the size of the array will increase. Okay, so here you got 5 values. So automatically size of the array becomes 5. Now you can use a loop, because since you are using a list of data items, that is list of elements in the array, you need to execute all the elements with the help of a loop. So the loop will be starting 0, because the position value of the first element is 0. So you have to start with 0 and it has to go on till 4. So you can put lesser than 5 so that the last element will be 4, will be listed in this. Now you are using system.println, and then you have to print this by giving the array variable open square bracket and the control variable, for variable, that is I, which will have the value 0 for the first element, so it will print 12. Then the loop will increase by 1. Now second time ARR will be, ARR of I will become 2, that is 1. So that will be the second element will be displayed. So it goes on like that till it reaches 4. So after that the program will stop. This is how you can assign the value in an array and then invoke the elements from the array variable and display it on the screen. The same way you are going to use character input. Only difference is you have to enclose these elements with single quotes. Otherwise everything is same. So you can see a character data type and then array variable, open and close square bracket, then equal to, then open curly braces, then all the elements within single quotes, and then close curly braces and semicolon. So remaining thing is the same. So if you display, if you execute this program, you will get the characters which is stored in the array. And next is string input. So if you are going to assign string values, you have to use string data type, array variable, open and close square bracket, and then equal to, within curly braces, you have to type the string within double quotes. That is, you have to enclose it within double quotes. You can see that string has been enclosed within the double quotes, and then a comma which is outside the double quotes, and then open and close double quotes, where you will type the next element, and goes on like that. So here, since you are having only three elements, you are having from 0 to 2. So it will display the string input, that is string output. Next is using DoJ system. So what you are going to do here is, you can see that public static void main statement itself, you can accept the array elements by using whatever data type it is. So here it is integer data type, so int, arr, open and close square bracket. Here also it is not defined, because you may not know how many numbers you are going to input. So according to the number you input, it will assign the memory space. That's why it is empty here. And now you can see an important line here, that is arr dot length. So it is starting from 0, the position number starts from 0, and it goes on till the array length. Okay. So what is this length will specify is, it will calculate the length of the array and display it, that it returns the length of the array. Suppose you are entering 4 numbers, it return 4. Since the position value is 0 to 3, you are using lesser than symbol. So this loop will work from 0 to 3. Okay. And then the remaining thing is same, you are going to display it. So when you compile this and execute it, it will open a method call, a message box, where you have to type the value. So you have to open curly braces and then type the elements. You can type any number of elements. According to that, the length will change. So no need to worry about it. You can type any number of elements, separate it by comma, and then click OK. Once you do that, according to the program, it will display the element. The same way, you can also input the character input using BlueJ system. Here, instead of integer, you have to put character. Remaining other things are same. You are going to find the length of the character array, and it will display it. Now here, what you can do, you can, after compiling and executing, in the method call message box, you have to open curly braces and then type the elements within single quotes separated by comma, and then close the curly braces and click OK. So automatically, according to the input, it displays the output. Same way, you are going to see how to use string input using BlueJ system. Here you have already seen this string args. Instead of that, you are writing string arr. Okay, it can be any variable. Okay, remaining thing is same. So here what you have to do is, after executing it, open curly braces, then within double quotes you have to give the element. Okay, type the string, then comma, then again you can continue that, and then close the curly braces. So if you execute it, you can see already curly braces will be available. You have to just type the values inside, but see that you type it within double quotes. Okay, otherwise you will get an error. So once you click OK, it will display the output. Then finally, you are going to see integer input using scanner class. Normally we used to have input stream, but we are not using buffer reader class. You are going to use scanner reader class. So we are going. I am going to give you an example for how to input using scanner class. This is a formal method. Here you are going to ask the user how many numbers you are going to input, how many elements you are going to input, and then according to that you can execute the program. So this is the formal way of declaring the array. So integer arr open and close bracket equal to new integer and within square bracket 5. So this example I have taken 5 elements. So I am giving it as 5. So the index numbers will be, that is the subscript values will be from 0 to 4. Okay, so I am giving the message outside the for loop. The reason is it will be displayed only once. Okay, and then you can see that the loop has been executed from 0 to 4 because you can see lesser than 5. So it is 0 to 4. And now you can see that how to get an input and store it into the array variable. So you can now right hand side you can see se dot next integer, because it is an integer value. So you are going to store you are going to use next integer. The value, the token, you are going to get it from the user terminal window. It will be stored in the array of the position given. So here I value is 0. So first number will be stored in arr of 0. Second value which you are given, which you will be giving, will be stored in the I plus plus, that is second value, that will be 1. So arr of 1 will store the second value, then arr of 2 will store the third value. So it goes on like that and it will store the input. Now after that you can display the output by just giving array elements R, and then you can execute the loop and then display the output which you already seen in the previous examples. And then when you execute it, the terminal window will ask you to enter 5 numbers. After entering the 5 numbers, so you can notice here you are leaving a space in between all the elements. After that, after entering 5 numbers, you can press enter, or you can enter each element and press enter. Once you reach 5 numbers, it automatically displays the output. Next is character. Remaining everything is same, only difference is the input, that is the declaration statement is different here, because you are, instead of integer, using character. And then you are going to use the input statement here, which you already seen in previous videos. So for inputting a character, you have to use se.next open and close parenthesis dot charret 0 open and close parenthesis 0 and then semicolon. So it will accept characters and then it will store it into the array variable. Otherwise it is same. And now when you execute it, we already seen how the output statement look like. So I am just showing the output screen how it is. So you have to enter 5 characters and it will display the character on the screen. Then finally you are going to see string input. So the data type you are going to use is string, and then the array variable has been used, and then you new operator, and then you are going to enter 5 strings. Okay, then you are going to use a loop statement to execute the input statement 5 times, so 0 to 4. So the array variable here, since it is a string, it is going to take the strings token by token. Okay, so first token will be a string, it will be stored in the position 0. So you can see the input here, enter 5 strings. You can see the different city names are given. So here Chennai will be stored in arr of 0. Okay, then Delhi will be stored in arr of 1. So it will be stored like that. And when you output also, you have to just display arr of I and start the value with 0 and then lesser than 5, so that it will display the all the elements which is available in the array. Hope you understood the concept of array, what is the necessity of an array, how to declare an array variable, and how to use it in different forms of input. Okay, so hope you understood this. We will meet in the next video. Till then, thank you.